women's 4x100-meter relay. The final, a race in which the United States is favored, a race in which the United States has four outstanding sprinters, but it's a fickle situation, as is all relay finals. If you drop the baton, that's it. Great Britain, Jamaica, the Bahamas, Trinidad and Tobago, the United States, Canada, Federal Republic of Germany, and France in lanes 1 through 8. Alice Brown to run the first leg. Jeanette Bolden in lane 2. Chandra Cheeseborough will run the third leg. And then Evelyn Ashford running the anchor leg for the United States with the United States team in lane 5. And I'm sure, OJ, you'd be surprised if anybody but the United States were to win this race as we take a look at the teams involved. Great Britain first in lane 1.
Yes, the United States has so many fine sprinters here. They are definitely capable of breaking a world record. It depends how aggressively they go after those passes and if they're willing to take a little gamble.
Janet Burke will lead things off for Jamaica in lane 2.
Angela Taylor.
Then from the Bahamas in lane 3, Elvisa Clark. Trinidad. Janice Bernard running the first leg in lane 4. The United States with Alice Brown, who won the silver in the open 100. She was second to Evelyn Ashford, so she is seeking her second medal of the games. She's running leadoff, followed by Bolden, Cheeseborough, and Ashford. Angela Bailey starts things off for Canada. She wound up in the 100 final for women and wound up sixth. Edith Oker of West Germany in lane 7. Uta Thiem will run anchor for West Germany as they try to win a medal. And it will be Rosamie Bacoul of France who wound up in the 200 final, who will start in lane 8.
Well, Alice Brown, who's leading off for us, had won. That's Bolden that you're looking at there. But Janet, Alice Brown had one excellent start in the semifinal this morning. She really made up the stagger on two of the runners. That's Chandra Cheeseborough. As you can see, she's already won her silver medal. Jeanette Bolden is the only one that hasn't won a medal here, so I guess she feels she has a lot at stake. And of course, that's the gold medal winner in the 100 meters, Evelyn Ashford. And we expect her anyway to have a real comfortable lead by the time she gets the baton. But once again, this is an excellent foursome, and they have an excellent chance of breaking a world record, but they're going to have a little better passing than they had this morning. This girl this morning, Alice Brown, was absolutely amazing. She literally caught the girl in front of her before they were halfway through the turn, and I expect her to get out real fast again in this race.
United States running 42.59 in the semis. Just about a second under the world mark, which is 41.60.
They're in an ideal lane. They're in lane 5. They get to look at one of their major competitors. The main competition should be lane 6, Canada, and lane 2, Jamaica. So we'll see one of the teams that if there's a team here that can push them, one of the teams that may be able to push that.
Alice Brown to lead off for the United States in lane 5. And it is a very good start for Alice Brown as she approaches Jeanette Bolden for the first pass. And it is Bolden who takes the baton. It's France looking good, too, on the outside. But Bolden, with Trinidad inside of her, ready to give it to Chandra Cheeseborough, who'll be running in both relays today. There's Cheese, number 370. Chandra Cheeseborough really turning it on, coming around the curve, and Evelyn Ashford is waiting for the baton. So the U.S. team is out in front, and here comes Evelyn with a tremendous lead. Will they get the world record? Ashford sprinting for the line. They're going to win this one by 15 meters, and it's Ashford crossing the line in 41.65. 12 100s off the world mark, and only 5 100s off the Olympic record. So Brown and Bolden and Cheeseborough and Ashford win the gold. Canada winds up second, and Great Britain finishes third.
Well, they went for it, and they had real fine passing. They had one problem. It wasn't a problem pass, but Alice Brown to Janet Bolden, when she got the baton, she had too much of it in her hand, so she was thinking about getting control of the baton before she really started to accelerate, and that was Bolden, but they were just a little off that record. They could have easily gotten it.
Evelyn Ashford has won her second gold medal. Chandra Cheeseborough has won her first gold medal, and Chandra will have a chance to win another later today when she's in the 4x400 relay, and Chandra's already won the silver in the open 400. So she is closing the Olympic Games with a tremendous glory. But there they are, Alice Brown, Jeanette Boland, Chandra Cheeseborough, and Evelyn Ashford. Their victory lap in front of a packed Coliseum.
Let's take a look at the passes. That's Alice Brown coming in to Jeanette. And you'll see it's a safe pass, not a great pass, but it's certainly not a bad pass. If anything may have hurt them, as you watch Janet get the baton, she gets too much of the baton in her hand, and she's thinking about the baton. See, she got too much of it in her hand, and now she's going to think about shimmying her hand up the baton to get the end of it so she can pass it off. And while you're thinking about that, you may not be accelerating as much as you should. You're not thinking about your stride. As you can see now, she shimmied her hand back and got all of it. Here she comes in, looking for Chandra Cheeseborough. That's Boland right there. This was the best pass of the group. Actually, the last pass was pretty good, too, but this is a very good pass. If the men can have passes equal to this, I think they'll break a world record today. She sort of ran up on her a little bit. They just entered the passing zone right there, so it's a little early. But it's good and low, and Chandra is... got good balance there. She got good control of the baton. And here she comes to Ashford. And this may be the best pass of the threesome here. It's Chandra in the middle of your screen. Once again, they want to play these passes pretty safe, but it's a quick pass. It's right in there. They spent no time looking for the hand. It was just in the hand, and actually, Ashford never had to break stride or anything. She just threw her hand back. The baton was there, and she was able to accelerate.
There's the very happy quartet circling the track at the Coliseum. 41.65 is the official time. And that's only 0.4 off the American record, the world mark 41.53, held by East Germany. The Olympic record, 41.60. The United States wins the gold. Canada takes the silver, and Great Britain wins the bronze in the women's 4x100 meter relay.